प्रभु जी, नो वॉइस. प्रभु जी, देयर इज नो वॉइस. प्रभु
Yeah, sorry. So, welcome all the devotees for today's session. Before we hear the Prabhupada's lecture, we'll go through the first. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Narayanam Namaskrityam Naram Chaiva Narottamam Devim Saraswatim Vyasam Tato Jayam Udirayat. Nashta Prayasho Badreshu Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya Bhagavati Uttama Shloke Bhaktir Bhavati Naishniki. So today is verse 31 from the first chapter of the sixth canto, which is continuation of the story of Ajamila. Vikarshato antar hridayad dasi patim ajamilam yama preshyana vishnuduta varayam asura ojasa. Synonyms: vikarshata, snatching, antah hridayad, from within the heart, dasi patim, the husband of the prostitute, ajamilam, ajamil, Yama Preshyan, the messengers of Yamaraj, Vishnu Dutaha, the order carriers of Lord Vishnu, Varayan Asuhu, forbid, Ojasa, with resounding voices. Translation: the order carriers of Yamaraj were snatching the soul from the core of the heart of Ajamil, the husband of the prostitute. But with resounding voices, the messengers of Lord Vishnu, the Vishnu Dutas, forbade them to do so. Purported by His Divine Grace, Swami Esi Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. A Vaishnava, one who has surrendered to the lotus feet of Lord Vishnu, is always protected by Lord Vishnu's order carriers. Because Ajamil had chanted the holy name of Narayan, the Vishnu Dutas not only immediately arrived on the spot, but also at once ordered the Yamadutas not to touch him. By speaking with resounding voices, the Vishnu Dutas threatened to punish the Yamadutas if they continued trying to snatch Ajamil's soul from his heart. The order carriers of Yamaraj have jurisdiction over all sinful living entities, but the messengers of Lord Vishnu, the Vishnu Dutas, are capable of punishing anyone, including Yamaraja, if wrong is done to a Vaishnava. Materialistic scientists do not know where to find the soul within the body with their material instruments, but this verse clearly explains that the soul is within the core of the heart, Hridaya. It is from the heart that the Yamadutas were extracting the soul of Ajamila. Similarly, we learn that the super soul, Lord Vishnu, is also situated within the heart. Ishvara Sarva Bhutanam Hridadeshu Arjuna Tishtati, Bhagavad Gita 18.61. In the Upanishads, it is said that the super soul and the individual soul are living in the same tree of the body as two friendly birds. The super soul is said to be friendly because the Supreme Personality of Godhead is so kind to the original soul that when the original soul transmigrates from one body to another, the Lord goes with him. Furthermore, according to the desire and karma of the individual soul, the Lord, through the agency of Maya, creates another body for him. The heart of the body is a mechanical arrangement. As the Lord says in the Bhagavad Gita 18.61, Ishvara Sarva Bhutanam Hridadeshu Arjuna Tishtati Dhamayan Sarva Bhutani Yantra Arudhani Mayaya. The Supreme Lord is situated in everyone's heart, O Arjun, and is directing the wanderings of all living entities who are seated as on a machine made of the material energy. Yantra means a machine such as an automobile. The driver of the machine of the body is the individual soul, who is also its director or proprietor. But the supreme proprietor is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. One's body is created through the agency of Maya, Karmana Daiva Netrena, which is mentioned in Srimad Bhagavatam, 3rd canto, 31st chapter, 1st verse. And according to one's activities in this life, another vehicle is created, again under the supervision of Daivi Maya. Daivehi Esha Gunamai Mam Maya Duratyaya, Bhagavad Gita 7.14. At the appropriate time, one's next body is immediately chosen, and both the individual soul and the super soul transfer to that particular bodily machine. This is the process of transmigration. During transmigration from one body to the next, the soul is taken away by the order carriers of Yamaraja and put into a particular type of hellish life, Naraka, in order to become accustomed to the condition in which he will live in his next body. Thus ends the Bhaktivedanta purport to this shloka. So we'll go ahead and listen to Prabhupada lecture. ओम अज्ञान तिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुरोन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। श्री चैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदांतिकं। वंदेहं श्री गुरो श्रीयुता पदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं सागरजातं सहगण रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजन सहितं श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य देवं श्रीराधा कृष्ण पादान् सहगण ललिता श्री विशाखान्वितांश्च। नमो विष्णुपदाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी नीति नामिने। नमस्ते सारस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषा शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैता गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंदम। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
Next is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 6th canto, 1st chapter, text number 31, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on July 16th, 1975, in San Francisco.
As the order carriers of Yamaraj were snatching out the soul from the core of the heart of Ajamil, the husband of the prostitute, the order carriers of Vishnu forbade them with great resounding voices to do so.
Mikarasito anta ridayad dasipotim ajaminam jamapreshan Vishnu duta barayamasu ojasa. So, when the order carriers of Jamrad were trying to take away Ajami from this world to the other lower planetary system below this universe, there are many planetary systems, they are called Patal, Tal, Atal, Nital, Talatal, Rasatal, Patal, same layers. So, below that layers there is hellish planets. Just like up there are heavenly planets, similarly down there are hellish planets. So Jamaraj, his kingdom, his jurisdiction is within these hellish planets. So, one point is very important. People are sometimes amazed, where is the soul? Now, it is clearly said here, it is the heart from the core of the heart. Therefore, soul is existing within the heart. And the Paramatma is also existing. The yogis, they want to see, although they are Paramatma and Jivatma sitting side by side, and he is dictating, but on account of our foolishness, we cannot see him, neither hear him. Antarbahi, he is within and he is without. But unfortunate as we are, we cannot see him either within or without. How it is possible? Just like a family member, your father or brother is playing on the stage, but he cannot see. Somebody is pointing, here is your brother dancing. He cannot see. Nato nato dharo jana. Just like person dressed in dramatic performance, his relative cannot see him. Similarly, Krishna is everywhere. Andantarasthang, paramanuchayantarasthang. Simply, one has to make his eyes purify to see him. Then he can see always Krishna within and without. Premanyana charita bhakti vilochane. This seeing is possible only in bhakti, not in jnana, karma. No, rather. Premanyana charita bhakti vilochane. No other method is prescribed. In Bhagavad Gita also, it is said, bhaktya mama vijanati javan jaschami tat. If you want to know Krishna as he is, then you have to know him through bhakti yogam, not any other. Others, they may go on speculating for many, many millions of years, still they will not be able to understand. Panthastu koti satavasta sampragamya vayurathapi manasu munipangavana sappasti jat prapadasimna avisinta tatti govindamadi purusam tamat. For many millions of years, running in the speed of mind and air, not this aeroplane speed. Aeroplane speed is at most 500-600 miles. But you just imagine the mind speed, 10,000 miles away, your mind can go immediately at a place where you had been. Mind is so speedy. Vayu, air is speedy, undoubtedly. But mind is still speedier. So even if you try to understand with the panthastu koti satavasta sampragamma, vayurathat, in the airplane, or vayurmanasa, airplane with the airplane has got different speed, but even if you go with the mind speed and time, panthastu koti satavas, hundreds and millions of years, still you will not be able to understand what is Krishna, what is God, if you speculate. But if you are a devotee, then you can see 24 hours Krishna. That is the difference. Andhastu koti satavasta sampra. So, this dasipati, this is also a significant word. The prostitute's husband. Prostitute means, they are in Sanskrit called pungshchali. Pungshchali means they are moved by other men. Pungshchali. There are three kinds of women. Sairindri, Pungshchali, and this way there are divisions. So some women, they are very easily carried by men. So, that is not very good. Therefore, I am instructing our devotees that let our little girls be educated to become faithful and chaste. That is their qualification. No education required. And the boys should be trained up to become first class. Rama Rama Titikha, like. And literary Sanskrit and English, that will make them perfect If the husband is first class and the wife is chaste and faithful, then the home is heaven. This is the formula. Dampato kalaho nasti tatra sri sayamagat. Murkha jatra napujyanti dhanna jatra susanchitam. Dampato kalaho nasti tatra sri sayamagat. Everyone is trying to become fortunate. Now, Chanaka Pandit gives three things. Formula. If you want to be fortunate, then do these three things. What is that? Murkha jatana pujyanta. Do not give any credit to the rascal. That is first part. Don't be carried away by the rascal. Murkha jatana pujyante. If you worship a rascal, then your life is spoiled. You must worship a really learned representative of God. That is very good. And dhanna jatra susanchitam, food grains, they are properly stocked. Not that for your food stock, getting your food grain or earning your livelihood, you have to go 100 miles, 50 miles. No. At home, you produce your food grain and stock. In India still, they work for 3 months during this rainy season.
Hare Krishna. So, can someone summarize what we have heard till now? Right from the shloka till this part where Srila Prabhupada is talking about stocking of grains. So, can someone start, please?
Hare Krishna. Vinod Nandini. So, Prabhupada started by describing various lokas beyond the beyond this planetary system. There are seven layers below the planetary system and above this planetary system as well. So there were dutas of Yamaruja, Yamaduta, Yamaraj, who are trying to take the soul of Ajamil to the lower planetary system because based on his karma. But he was describing not Prabhupada, but when you summarized, so it was mentioned that even Vishnu Dutas came down and then they fought against the Yamadutas and then. He was not taken by the Yamadutas, in fact. So, because he was Ajamil was in company of the prostitute. He was describing about the lifestyle of the Ajamil. So Ajamil was in company of the prostitute, and it was described that there were three kinds of woman. I don't remember those names, but it was described that there are three kinds of women. One woman, one kind is like who would be staying with moving with different men. So that was one kind of the woman. And so Prabhupada was mentioning that from here someone can continue. Prabhuji.
Thank you very much, Prabhuji. You have started off really well. So can someone add other points, please?
Hare Krishna Prabhu, Dhanat Pranam. So I remembered one point. So So we can see the Lord with only bhakti. Only bhakti only we can see the Lord. In any other way, we cannot. It is not possible to see the Lord. So bhakti yoga na something, some sloga is given by Prabhupada. And yeah, so that point I remember. Yeah, Chanakya Pandit says, so yeah, so we have to worship the right person. The right person we have to worship. So we should not worship the rascal. That's what clearly said by Chanakya Pandit. One point. That's what I remember, bro. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Dandat Pranam. इस श्लोक में शायद प्रभुपाद जी से बता रहे हैं कि यदि यमराज भी गलती करते हैं विष्णु के बारे में तो उन्हें भी दंड देने का विष्णु दूतों को अधिकार है. इतना मेरी समझ में आया है. हरे कृष्णा.
हरे कृष्णा माता जी. कैन समवन ऐड द अदर पॉइंट्स प्लीज.
हरे कृष्णा. दंड प्रणाम. So he is mentioning that the heart, the soul is situated in the core of the heart. This we know by that Ishvara Sarva Bhutana Hrideshe Arjuna Tishtati. And also mentioning that according to one's karma, one gets a body into various species which happens under Deiva Netrena. So one assumes so many bodies. This is transmigration. And like there are heavenly planets, there are also Atala, Vitala, Patala, Talatala and all that. So according to that, you will be put into those, this thing. So because when Ajamila was on his deathbed, when the Yamadutas came, the Vishnudutas also came because he had mentioned the word Narayan. So as Mataji mentioned, the Vishnudutas have power even to control Yamaraja's activities. Hare Krishna. And like Prabhuji mentioned, we can see Lord only through Payamanjana Churita Bhakti Vilochanena and not through speculation. So a devotee is capable of seeing the Lord all 24 hours. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. Very well said. Can someone add other points? I'll start. So basically we saw in the verse, as Mataji has mentioned, the question which the material scientists today have, where is this energy which is controlling this body? So they don't understand this energy is soul first. And then they want to find where is the source of that energy, which again they don't understand, that it is already mentioned in our Shastras. So if you remember the last week's lecture, Prabhupada ji has said that everything is there in our Shastras, in our Vedic culture. Its only thing is we cannot see them with this material eyes. We need to develop the Shastra Chakshu. So the exact location of the soul is mentioned as heart. And additionally, if we go through the verse and the lecture, Prabhupada ji has clearly mentioned again, it is not alone. It is with the Paramatma. So the Vedas give the example of but Atma and Paramatma as two friendly birds. Now, why they are called as friendly birds is because Paramatma is so kind that wherever the Atma is going, Paramatma is accompanying. So, and not only accompanying, he is also through the energy, the Maya, creating appropriate body as per the desires and wishes of this Atma. So that is the kindness of Paramatma, who in the transmigration process is always with us. So when we go further in this lecture, we'll have one more location where Prabhupada ji is talking about Paramatma and Atma. Thereafter, as Prabhuji mentioned, he has talked about the hellish planets. So seven hellish planets below and seven heavenly planets above on which and we are here. So Yamaraja basically has the control over the hellish planets only. And Vishnudutas have got so much energy and Krishna has so much of kindness for the Vaishnavas and the devotees that they do not allow Yamaraj also to do anything to Vaishnavas. So if someone is doing any mistake to Vaishnavas, Prabhupada mentions in the lecture, Vishnudutas can punish them, what to talk of even Yamaraja also. So indirectly what Prabhupada is saying is, we have to be very careful with our Vaishnava aparas. We have to ensure that we do not do Vaishnava aparas, because otherwise Krishna gets dissatisfied and Vishnudutas are coming to punish. So Vaishnava respect, maintenance is very important. But then the question still arises, if so much is there and Paramatma is there with us, Atma is there in us, why is it not seen? So Krishna is described as Antarbhai, he is within and he is without. But we are not able to see because we don't have that netra, the proper vision to see it. So, and as has been mentioned, so we have this Brahma Samhita, where this shloka is there, Premanjana Churitena Bhakti Vilochanena, or even in Bhagavad Gita, wherein Krishna says, Bhaktya Mam Avijanati Yavan Nyasa Chachmi Tatvataha. So it's only with Bhakti Yoga that we can see Krishna, otherwise Krishna is everywhere. Everywhere Krishna is there. Andhatarastha Paramanucha Antarastha Sthitam. So that is again mentioned in Brahma Sahita. So Krishna is everywhere. Only thing is, we need to develop that bhakti by which we can see it. Then only we will be able to understand Krishna. Otherwise, whether we drive with running like aeroplane or anything, even at the speed of mind, if we go for thousands of years, we will go ahead and still we will not be able to see Krishna. Pantastu kotishata vatsara sampragamyo vayo rathapi. So that is what has been mentioned till now. And then we have this Chanakya's mantra, Chanakya's sutra being talked about by Prabhupada ji for happiness. So we'll continue the lecture further and then understand what these Chanakya sutras are further.
And they get their food grains for the whole year. You can save time so nicely. So these things are required for a happy home. There must be food grains. You cannot be happy without eating, that is not possible. Annad bhavanti, Krishna also says in the Bhagavad Gita, Annad bhavanti bhutani. If you have got sufficient anna, eatables, foodstuff, then you become happy. So three things. One thing, that at home no rascal should be received or given care. According to Vedic system, at home a sannyasi is welcome. A brahmana is welcome, because they will give good instruction, they are welcome. Just like when Gaurgumani came to Maharaj Nanda Maharaj's house, how nice reception he gave. That is the especially, of course, any guest is welcome, but especially a brahmana, a sannyasi, is very well received. Still in Indian village, if a sannyasi goes, he has no problem for eating or staying residence. Everyone will request, Swamiji, today you take prasadam at my place. So there are many villagers, so he can stay 3 days, 4 days, so there is no scarcity. Still, they will invite you, please come, take prasadam. So, because, why this system? Because sannyasi means you'll give good instruction, spiritual knowledge, but that is his business, paribrajaka acharya, wandering all over the world and giving good instruction. Therefore, paribrajaka. Paribrajaka means wandering and acharya means teaching. Paribrajaka acharya. This is sannyasi's business. So, they must be well received. At the present moment, if a sannyasi is trying to enter in some householder's house, immediately the doorman, please get out, get out, get out. Because some of the sannyasis, they have taken this dress as a means of livelihood. But still, in the village, any sannyasi, he may be a cheater, still he is welcome. In the cities, of course, in India, they are now doubtful whether he is actually sannyasi or to fill up his belly he has taken this dress. So, this is the formula. A very learned man, generally the sannyasi and brahmanas, they should be worshipped, not the fool sannyasi. So, murkha jatra napujyante and dhanna jatra, dhanna means paddy, rice, well stock. Perhaps here in your country also it is called burn, that you keep. So you have got big stock, that is required. There may be scarcity at time, but if you keep stock, then there is no trouble. But this one, no police rascal should worship, food grains should be nicely stocked, and the third thing, most important, dambato kalaha nasti. There is no disagreement between husband and wife. If these three things are there, then you haven't got to pray to the goddess of fortune, kindly be merciful. She will automatically go. Here is a very nice place. I shall stay. This Ajami, he was Dasipati. He was a husband of a prostitute. So he was not happy. He was attached. Another thing is, that is also Chanaka Pandit. He said, Dushtabhajya. Dushtabhajya means this prostitute. Dushta, who is polluted by another man. He is called Dushta. Srisu Dushtasu Varna Sankara Vibhavati. Therefore human civilization must be very careful that the woman may not become polluted. Srisu Dushtasu, Dushta means she is not satisfied with husband. She wants new. That is called Dushta. So Chanaka Pandit says, Dushta Bharja. If the wife is Dushta, Dushta Bharja, Sadhanga Mitram, and friend is Sadhang, hypocrite, talking very friendly, but he has got something desired. That is called Sadhanga Mitram. Sadhang means hypocrite. So, if somebody's wife is Dushta and friend is hypocrite, Dushta Bharja Sadhanga Mitram, Bhittasta Uttaradayaka, and Bhitta servant does not obey, he argues with the master. Master says, why did you not do? Oh, I am this. No, Bhitta should be very silent. Then he is faithful, sir. Sometimes master may be angry, but Bhitta should be silent. Then master becomes kind. But if he replies on equal level, then it is very bad. Dushta bhaja satanga mitram bhittasta uttradayaka sasatpeta grihivas. And you are living in an apartment where there is a snake. So if these four things are there, or one of them, not all the four, then mrityurevana sangshaya, then you are doomed. Your life is spoiled. Vishtabhadya satamitram mrityasya uttaradayaka sasarpeja grihivasa mrityurevana. So this man married a prostitute, Vishtabhadya, and he learned how to cheat, how to become fraud. So many we have already discussed. That was his business. And he was very nicely, you are thinking, I am very nicely situated. In this way, he was a little attached to the youngest child. That was his fortune, that he was named Narayana. That is Krishna's kindness. Krishna is so kind, so merciful to his devotee, that Uddhava says that Krishna is so kind.
Hare Krishna. So, can someone summarize? Can someone start from the sutras which Chanakya Prabhuji has, Chanakya has given about family, happy family.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, Dandav Pranam. Yes, so Prabhupada was mentioning this first verse that Murkha Yatra Na Pujanti, one should not worship a rascal. Dhanyam Yatra Susan Chitam, that one should store the sufficient stock, food grains in his home. And Dampatyo Kalayo Nasti, and one should not have fight between a husband and wife. There should be happy family. Then Tatra Shri Swayam Agataha. Then the goddess of fortune will herself come and bless the family. One should not have to do special endeavor for that. So this verse was Chanakya Prabhupada was quoting. And the another verse Prabhupada was quoting about Chanakya Pandit, that Dushta, there's one verse that I will just tell the translation, that what it means, that if one has a cheating wife, and first, this is the first thing, and the second thing is satam mitram, one, if one has a hypocrite friend and a vrityas chotara dayakaha, and if one has a servant which does not obey the master, and if one has a serpent in his home, the snake in his home, then mrityu revana samshaya, then his life is spoiled, finished. There shlokas Prabhupada quote of Chanakya Pandit. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
हरे कृष्णा. इस श्लोक में प्रभुपद जी बताते हैं कि ब्राह्मण और इन्हें एक विलेज, बहुत सारे विलेजर्स विलेज है, इंस्ट्रक्शन देते अपने लाइफ में, इंस्ट्रक्शन देते हैं, इसलिए उन्हें कोई बात की चिंता नहीं रहती कि अब मैं कहाँ जाऊंगा तो मुझे कुछ प्रसाद मिलेगा या नहीं मिलेगा. हर कोई उन्हें अजमिल एक दासी पति थे. दासी पति
हरे कृष्ण माता जी. सो quite couple of points, maybe there was some connectivity issues from your end, but you have added good points about why sannyasi is give a reward. So We'll allow others also to add points, then we'll summarize. Can someone add other points, please?
Hare Krishna, Dandat Pranams.
Dandat Mataji. Yes, Mataji, you are audible.
Okay, Hare Krishna. So I especially like this point of Britya, what Srila Prabhupada is very nicely explaining. Britya means a servant is a person who has to listen to the master without cross-questioning. Because as a servant, we are all, as when we get initiated, we get the names of Dasa and Dasi, which means that we have to follow the instructions of our spiritual master. And Srila Prabhupada very beautifully explains here that one should not cross-question or talk in an equal level with the master, but rather, even if the master scolds, one has to be silent. Because as a Britya, or as a servant, one has to be very careful to choose his master. And once having chosen his master, one has to be completely obedient and submissive to the master. So that's a very nice point, which I thought is very much applicable for even advancement in spiritual life. Because we all take shelter of our spiritual master. And one of the most important thing, which is also mentioned in Bhagavad Gita, is tadvidhi pranipatena pariprashnena sevaya. So we have to be submissive to the spiritual master. And even if we have some query, we have to ask in a submissive way. We should not, in this verse, what Srila Prabhupada is explaining is, we should not talk back or we should not cross-question, but rather, we can ask in a submissive way, and we have to be silent and just follow the instructions of the spiritual master, or the master, as Prabhupada has given here. Thank you. Hare Krishna. Dandat Pranams.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. Very valid point and very important. Can someone add a few other points from practical aspect which Prabhupada has said in this lecture till now?
Hare Krishna. So one more point what I wanted to add is in the last part. So all the four, Ajamil was actually surrounded by all the, his wife was a prostitute. Fallen down, he engaged in, his Mitra was also, all those people who engaged in, non-dharmic activities. But in spite of all that, just because he called out the name of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Narayan, immediately he was removed from the most abominable condition, right? So it gives us the potency of chanting the holy names of the Lord. How anyone from any state of being can be immediately liberated and can reach the highest platform simply by chanting the Hare Krishna Mahamantra or the holy names of the Lord. Just like how Ajamil, he reached the highest position from where he could progress in his devotional service simply by chanting the holy name of Lord Narayan. Hare Krishna. Dandavats.
Very valid point, Mataji. So that Prabhupada is going to explain further in this last part. So basically, from practical aspect, this Charakya Sutra is very important. So Prabhupada has mentioned why in ISKCON he was concentrating on training the next gen, the children. So he has said that we should be training the Matajis on how to become more chaste and faithful, and Prabhujis on how to become first class men. That is what he has mentioned. Because if there is no kalha in the family, then only there will be happiness. And if there is happiness, then everything will come follow automatically. So that is one of the important points. And then regarding sannyasis, he has also mentioned. So every day in the morning, when we are giving our obeisances after the aarti, we generally say, Jai Om Vishnupad Paramaswara Vijagacharya Shtottar Shri Srimad Krishna Krupa Shri Murti Bhakti Vedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. So this Parivrajakacharya word is very important. So he is explaining what this Parivrajak Acharya means. So Parivrajak means the duty of a sannyasi is that he should be going all over the world. And Acharya means he has to be a teacher. So that is the actual duty of a sannyasi, that he should be moving around and giving training on the spiritual subjects, on what the real identity is and how to achieve our real identity and our ultimate aim of life, of going back to Godhead. And then Chanakya has explained how we should be careful about these four aspects. That is Dushta Striya, that is a wife who is not chaste. Secondly, about a friend who is not actually your friend, but who thinks something else. Thirdly, is a servant who is not obedient to you. And fourthly, a snake who is living in your house. So if you are not careful about it, then definitely you are going to die, as Prabhupada is summarized in the very first part of this session. So we'll continue with the last part of the session and then summarize the whole lecture.
That Putana came to poison Krishna. She smeared poison on her breast. They made a policy that I shall take the child very affectionately and push the nipple in his mouth, and as soon as the child will drink the poison, he will die. And Krishna is so kind that although her motive was to kill Krishna, Krishna took the bright side. What is that? Oh, I have sucked her breast, so she is my mother. Krishna is taken. And therefore, after death, Putana got the same position as Mother Yashoda. So Krishna is so kind. Who can kill Krishna? So, for Krishna there is no black side or bright side. If Krishna can drink oceans of poison, so, that he did not take very seriously, that these witches have come to poison me. But she has agreed to give me milk from her breast, then she is my mother. This is Krishna's conduct. Therefore, Uddhava says, such a kind Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, that the enemy, the poison giver was accepted as mother, so whom I shall worship except Krishna? This should be the conclusion. That Krishna is so kind, little service. So this Ajamil, and in the beginning of his life, he was being trained up by his father, first class Brahmin, Vaishnava. But he fell a victim to the prostitute, and he forgot everything. But Krishna noted that he has done something for me. Salpam api asya dharma sa trayati mahato bhaya. Devotional service, he sincerely done little only. That is also taken just like the Putana. He had no desire, but still, consciously, unconsciously, she gave some service. Similarly, we should try our best to give some service to Krishna. If little service is sincerely given, Krishna takes note of it, and his business is protective. Even though you fall down, just like Ajami. So Ajamil fell down very deeply from the standard of Brahman, Vaishnava. But Krishna saved him, that this man has got very much attraction for the child. So let him have the name Narayana. That dictation was given by Krishna. Better keep your son's name Narayana. So, he was attached to the son, always chanting Narayana. Narayana, please come. Narayana, please eat. Narayana, please sit down. So at the time of death, he loudly chanted Narayana. He thought his son will save him from the hands of this Jamadut. But immediately Krishna's attendants immediately came there, Vishnu Duta. And immediately they ordered, "You Yama Duta, carry your subordinate. Stop, you cannot do it." That is stated here. Yama Prashan Vishnu Duta Barvayamasa. Do not touch him. Ojasa, very strongly. And if you touch, then you will be punished. Don't do it. Ojosa means very strong. Just like a master orders the servant, you have to it. Similarly, ojosa. This is the benefit of becoming Vaishnava and chanting. If we chant offenselessly, this man had no offense. He was misguided accidentally, but he did not commit any offense. He did not perform all sinful activities that I am now chanting Narayana, so it is being nullified. And so let me go on doing these sinful activities and chant Narayana. No, he did not do so. He did not know. What is the benefit of chanting Narayana's name? He did not know. So therefore, unconsciously, he was offenseless. Now, the next discussion is very interesting. Thank you very much.
Hare Krishna. So, can someone summarize, please?
Hare Krishna, Nandatnam. Hare Krishna.
Yes, Mataji.
Okay, Hare Krishna. So, Srila Prabhupada starts this section by giving example of Putana. Putana actually smeared her breast with poison with the intention of actually killing Krishna. She had approached Krishna, and Krishna, because he sucked the breast of Putana and drank milk from her, he actually, irrespective of the intention of Putana, he actually gave the position of mother to Putana. So Srila Prabhupada is explaining here, Svalpam apiyasya dharmasya trayate mahato bhayat. Even a little service done to Lord Krishna, Krishna never forgets. And Srila Prabhupada is drawing a parallel to Ajamil, how he was trained by his father with the Brahminical and Vaishnava principles and culture. And although he followed it very nicely, later on he had an accidental fall down. And got attached to a prostitute because of the services that he had done as a child following his father, Lord Krishna gave him the intelligence to name his son as Narayan. So Krishna gave the intelligence to Ajamil to name his son as Narayan, and he was attached only to his son. He was not even attached to the Lord. But Krishna ensured that whatever services Ajamil has performed to him, he is not forgotten. That's why he gave him the intelligence. And by just calling his son Narayan, he was from the lowest state that he was in. He directly became at the state where he can directly call the benefit of calling the Supreme Personality of Godhead Narayan. He got that benefit, and then he could proceed from there. So this helps us to understand that any amount of service, whether very small or whatever is according to our capacity, if we always render service to Lord Krishna, Krishna never forgets, and that small service might will protect us from the greatest type of fear, like in the case of Ajamil. Hare Krishna, Danat Pranams.
Hare Krishna Mataji, very, very well summarized. So, would anyone like to add any other point after what Mataji has summarized?
Hare Krishna Prabhuji. Yes, and Prabhupada said at the last that even though Jamil was doing sinful activities, but his fall down was accidental. And Vishnu Dutas came for his rescue because the Narayan he was chanting, it was offenseless chanting, because he was not chanting the name of Narayana, thinking that by chanting the name of Narayana, it will nullify my sinful activities. So Jamil's chanting was offenseless. That's why Vishnu Duta came for his rescue. And so one should be careful of these offenses, the 10 offenses of chanting the holy name. And one should chant Hare Krishna Ma Mantra in offenseless states. Then life is perfect. Hare Krishna.
Very bold, Prabhuji. Very nicely mentioned. So, anyone would like to add any other point? So, just what Dhiraj Prabhuji has mentioned about 10 offenses. So, which is the biggest offense which Prabhupada is mentioning?
Prabhupada ji ne jo 10 naam apradhe, usme se ek apradh hai, naam ke bal pe apradh karna. Yani hum naam le rahe hain aur hamare paap dhul jayenge. ऐसे समझ के हम पाप ही करते रहे तो उसका कुछ फायदा नहीं है. ऐसे कुछ
Prabhuji, you are not audible, I think. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Yeah. That is audible. Sorry, there was some problem. Yeah. So, that is the biggest offense which Prabhupada ji has mentioned in the lecture. Namno baladyasi papa buddhi. So, offenseless chanting is very important. See, Krishna is merciful, which Uddhav is saying. So, even with little service we do, Krishna is going to be pleased. But we have to be careful. Throughout the lecture, Prabhupada has given us 2 points, which are very important. One, careful against Vaishnava Aparad and careful against Nama Aparad. If we are able to do offenseless chanting, then even if it is swalpa, even if it is small, Krishna is going to be pleased and we will be getting the due course, whatever is our intention of going back to Godhead. So chanting, and that too, offenseless chanting, is very important for getting the vibrations and the training to the tongue, so that Krishna himself reveals to us what our real position is and takes us along. And then it is only because of offenseless chanting that the Yamdutas felt this anxiety which was there in the name, the calling out of by Ajamil of O Narayan, that they got attracted and helped him. So in last week we had seen he was not calling it 3 times, he called only once, but he called it with so much of anxiety that it immediately attracted the Vishnu Dutas. So that anxiety, that belongingness, longingness for Krishna has to come out of our chanting. And then it is going to be successful. So these are the 2 things we should take away from this lecture, that we have to cleanse our heart. And the way of cleaning the heart is bhakti yoga. And how we do the bhakti yoga is through offenseless chanting. So I thank you all for coming. We have similar sessions every day. We have in the evening. Also, we have Bhagavad Gita. Then we have Bhagavatam. And then we have the conglomeration. So right from 7:30 p.m., we have good sessions. So I request all of you to take opportunity to join those sessions as well. And if possible, do come for the physical classes as well, especially on Sunday for the Sunday feast programs. So association is something which is the beginning of ABCDs. So that is something which will be very useful. So see you again in the evening at 7 p.m. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.